fuerte.
It is our main event. The World Boxing Super Series has come to the United States. Here in San Antonio at the Alamo Dome, Yunel Dordikos, defending his WBA Cruiserweight Championship, taking on the challenger, Dmitry Kudryashov. Kudryashov making his United States debut. A trip to the semifinals of the World Boxing Super Series is on the line. Ray Flores, BJ Flores here.
Nice jab to the body by Kudryashov right in the beginning. I'm going to say Dmitry because it's a little difficult for me to say that name for the whole fight, but comes out and sets a nice left, hard left jab to the body of Dordikos.
Is that or the Russian hammer, and Dordikos sends a right hand right down the middle, but answering back with the jab is Kudryashov.
Good right hand by Dmitry right in the beginning. He did a little pull counter. And you just see the heavy-handedness of Dmitry. Really sits down on those punches, gets a lot of good leverage. Doesn't really worry about the speed as much, just the timing and the power.
For the Russian hammer, 8 first-round finishes. Dordikos, 10 first-round finishes. So they like to finish their fights rather early. A big right hand that backs up Dordikos momentarily by Kudryashov.
A lot of nice leverage on that right hand, Ray. You see Dordikos shoot the jab, kind of turn his body, and then really leverage that right hand. Even though the guard of Dmitry Kudryashov is up, it's still splitting through there and making contact. Trust me, those still hurt.
Just a 1-inch height advantage for Dordikos. He's 6'3" compared to 6'2" for Kudryashov. And now Dordikos is going downstairs with the body, a left followed by a straight right.
And he's got to be careful not to unload too much too early on Kudryashov, because he's got the ability to change the fight with one punch, Ray, and he's got very heavy hands, and we've seen it in fights past. It is opponents get a little too comfortable, they come forward looking to open up, and he ends things very quickly and abruptly. Not to mention he's got those HO and Mexico Everlast gloves on, which are the closest things to Reyes, which you can literally feel the knuckle coming through. So those things are not comfortable to get hit with, and I think Kudryashov knows that.
Jab to the body by Kudryashov to Dordikos.
Nice left hook.
Hook there. It has been Kudryashov, who's been more active in his career, having coming off a win back on June 3rd over Olajemi Durodola. Avenging his only loss.
Another good jab by Dmitry. Right now, they're just kind of taking turns shooting combinations. I would like to see in the interim time, if you're either fighter, use that left jab to control the tempo a little more. Kudryashov is punching, and then Dordikos is punching. In the lull, land that jab. Nice right hand by Dordikos.
The action is picking up as we near the final stages of round one. This is the quarterfinals of the World Boxing Super Series. A trip to the semifinals is on the line.
I like that little head movement that Dmitry is showing up top. His hands are up, and it looks like he's just looking to block on the guard, but he's using a little subtle side-to-side movement to set up that left uppercut and that left hook. I like that. Very close competitive first round.
They're letting the leather fly, but I'm sure it is going to come off even that much more intensive. And it ends the first round, a shot after the bell by Dordikos as Kudryashov goes back to his corner.
So much intensity between those after that punch landed, Ray, and you can see both guys aren't willing to give an inch.
Nothing whatsoever. Eric Castaños is in the corner of Dordikos. Manny Robles is in the corner of Kudryashov. Take a look at some of the action here, and that was after, and look at the stare down between both men. And Dordikos blew a kiss. My goodness, some theatrics. From Dordikos to Kudryashov.
Pretty much just letting them know, hey, I'm not going anywhere. And I know you're mad about that. And guess what? I don't care. So a lot of good intensity from both guys. And this is the type of presence, this is the type of atmosphere you get when two guys are fighting for a world championship. Everything's on the line. They've trained their entire lives for this moment, and they're not willing to give anything.
Dordikos backing up Kudryashov momentarily. He is really starting to open up. A crushing right hand down the middle as Dordikos is really unloading and trying to stop Kudryashov early here tonight.
Some of the keys to victory earlier that I thought that I made notes of is the hand speed of Dorticos. He doesn't want to get in the wheelhouse with Kudryashov because Kudryashov has the heavier hands, but Dorticos has the advantage of hand speed. Make no mistake about it. And you saw that in the beginning of the second round.
BJ, are you surprised that Dorticos is staying in the pocket as much as he is against Kudryashov?
He's standing in the pocket, yes, Ray, but he's still able to go ahead, move his head side to side and use angles to land that right hand, so he's not right in the wheelhouse. Good work from Dorticos.
Dorticos is unloading big right hands down the middle, and Kudryashov is eating them and still throwing back with the left hook.
You saw he was hurt. He was momentarily wobbled, Ray, and he's looking to counter the Dorticos right hand with his own left hook. Kudryashov is waiting for that shot, catching it on the gloves and coming back with his counter left hook. But he better be careful because he's taking way too many of those right hands.
Let's take a look. 45% connect percentage for power punches in favor of Dorticos. Dorticos has really started very strong here in the second round. But Kudryashov isn't going anywhere.
You see that heavy left hook? After Dorticos, you're going to want to start to get underneath some of those punches. Use the weave. When you make the big guy miss, make him tired. If you catch the shot in the gloves, you don't get near as tired. So make him miss some of those big left hooks he leads up on.
Manny Robles was adamant, instructing to the Russian hammer that he wants to double jab. He wants to see more of the double jab from Kudryashov. And a right hand that puts him down. And this one may be it. Oh, my goodness.
The hand speed, this fight's over, Ray. He hit him with that hard right hand. We talked about it. He's the knockout doctor. And they call him that for a reason. This fight's over.
The KO doctor has knocked out Kudryashov. You know Dorticos is a very, very bad man retaining his WBA Cruiserweight Championship here in San Antonio. That was as vicious and wow, what a straight right hand. You saw Kudryashov, his eyes rolled in the back of his head.
We saw the hand speed of Dorticos in the beginning. We talked about it before the fight. This fight's not going the distance, and he slid in one of those counters. We talked about the ring IQ, the intelligence of Dorticos, how he was able to make Kudryashov miss. He did that, and he hit him with the right hand that he'll never forget, Ray.
That was a vicious right hand. He started strong in the second, and boy, oh boy, did Yunel Dorticos put the rest of the tournament field on notice as, my goodness, what an emphatic second round knockout here tonight.
And he wasn't even loading up, right? He was able to get the job done without having to load up on those punches. He's simply heavy-handed, and when you make a guy miss and he's off balance, you're able to land that type of punch, that debilitating power that Dorticos presents. Stand up, Cuba.
I know that, and let's take a look. BJ, walk us through it.
And you see him land the overhand right there, but you see he's missing those punches. Kudryashov shot that right hand. He's able to miss, and there was little gaps, there's little small areas that Dorticos was able to take advantage. You see Kudryashov standing tall, using the guard to block, but then when he misses that left hook, he's off balance just enough for Dorticos to slide that right hand in, and the hand speed wasn't enough, and it was just a big difference tonight.
And watch the body language. There you see that right hand. He got everything behind that straight right hand. Boom, on the button. And as Kudryashov went to the canvas, his eyes almost rolled to the back of his head, and he was literally looking up at the lights.
And that's the type of punch you never want to get hit with. And they tell you, you know what, bring the punch back to home base. Don't swing for the fences every time because you get off balance. Why? Because when you get off balance, you're in a position to get hurt, and that's exactly what happened tonight. Just a nice, solid, loose performance from Dorticos. And just when it was time for him to step on the gas pedal, it's exactly what he did.
And that is the ref cam that Rafael Ramos saw. And look at the emotion from the 31-year-old, Yunel Dorticos. Defends his WBA Cruiserweight Championship for a first time and successful. And there you see Rafael Ramos, and Kudryashov doesn't know where he is.
Yeah, he was separated from his senses, Ray. A right hand like that in the temple area early in the fight. He wasn't completely loose or warmed up yet, but you can't take clean punches like that, and that's what we talked about. You don't want to swing too hard in the beginning because it leaves opportunities for your opponent to counter.
That is a start to the World Boxing Super Series here in the United States. Yunel Dorticos with a second round starching of Dmitry Kudryashov. That is a very happy camp with Eric Castaños, his trainer, and Louis DeCubis, senior who was guiding the career of Roberto Duran. And look at the emotion there.
And we talked about it before. We talked to some of the executives of the World Boxing Super Series Tournament. Dmitry Kudryashov was one of their favorites. A lot of people thought this guy was going to the finals. Why? Because he possesses that one-punch power. But we talked about this. You have to set up the power shot. You can't just go out there looking to load up with one or two at a time. And Torticos used his experience and took complete advantage of the situation.
Well, the KO doctor gave some medicine to Dmitry Kudryashov. Compliments of that straight right hand down the middle that literally separated him from his senses. His legs were gone immediately, BJ.
Yeah, they were. And, you know, looking about a little further down the tournament, who does Torticos match up with next? What kind of matchup is it? And it just creates a lot of excitement for this entire tournament, this entire bracket.
Well, now Torticos will fight the winner of Gassiev and Vladarchuk. That'll happen on October 21st at the Prudential Center in New Jersey. Sign me up for what, however that shakes out. My goodness. And now we will set it up to our ring announcer. Here's Jimmy Lennon Jr. with the particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2:10 in round number 2. Our referee in charge, Rafael Ramos, reaches the count of 10. He is the winner by way of knockout. He is continuing to the semifinals of the World Boxing Super Series. He is still the undefeated WBA Cruiserweight Champion of the World, proving true to his nickname, the KO Doctor Yunihe.
Right now, we are going to be joined alongside by the victorious Yunel Torticos.